5 seconds to go. Start. I welcome you to this meeting to review the situation in the states most affected by left-wing extremism. I am grateful to the Prime Minister for agreeing to chair this meeting. The last meeting of Chief Ministers on internal security was held on February 7, 2010. In my opening remarks at that meeting, I had cautioned that there was a rise in the number of incidents of violence in 2009 and that it is possible that this trend will continue in 2010 too. During the period January to June 2010, there have been 1,103 incidents of violence perpetrated by left-wing extremists, while 97 extremists were killed and 1,341 apprehended. 209 members of the security forces also lost their lives. These figures underscore the gravity of the challenge posed by left-wing extremism. You are aware that the CPI, MAYOST, is the principal left-wing extremist organization. As long the CPI, MAYOST, was not challenged effectively, it expanded its area of activity, recruited more cadres, kidnapped more persons, extorted more money, acquired or looted more weapons, asserted its dominance in more areas, and targeted the security forces as well as civilians. Among the civilians, the CPI MAYOST specially targeted civilians who it named as police informers. Between 2004 and 2008, on an average, 500 civilians were killed every year, and many of them were killed after being named police informers. In 2009, 591 civilians were killed, of which 211 were named as police informers. This trend has continued in the first half of 2010 too, with 325 civilians killed, of which 142 were named as police informers. We are especially concerned that ordinary citizens should be labeled as police informers and killed by the CPI MAYOST. The CPI MAYOST has no right to set itself up as judge, jury, and executioner. In fact, it has no right to carry arms. It is a banned organization and functions outside the pale of the law. The state governments and the central government cannot ignore these self-evident facts. Since the first meeting of chief ministers on internal security held on January 6, 2009, we have agreed upon a two-pronged strategy, namely development and police action. Since then, we have remained on course, and in subsequent meetings at New Delhi and in the state capitals, we fine-tuned the strategy in accordance with state-specific requirements. The efforts of the state governments, assisted by central paramilitary forces, have met with mixed results. Key leaders of the CPI MAYOST have been apprehended. Many attacks were repulsed. Security forces have asserted their control over some areas in the districts of Gadchiroli and Kankade. However, there have been setbacks too. The most serious setbacks were in Selda, West Bengal, and in Tarmetla, Chingavaram, and Dodai, all in Chhattisgarh. Besides, there was the derailment of the Ganeshwari Express that claimed the lives of 149 innocent civilians. While there have been some lapses on the part of the security forces, in failing to follow standard operating procedure, there can be no gainsaying that the attacks by the CPI mayost were premeditated and carried out with the object of inflicting maximum damage on the security forces and overawing the people and the elected governments. We would do well to remember that the attacks by the CPI mayost, whether opportunistic or pre-planned, are part of their strategy of armed liberation struggle and in furtherance of their goal of seizure of political power through protracted people's war. The central government acknowledges the primary role and responsibility of the state governments in enforcing law and order and in confronting the challenge of left-wing extremism. We also acknowledge the role and responsibility of the central government to assist the state governments in every way, deploying central paramilitary forces, sharing intelligence, funding the modernization of police forces, and providing logistics and other support. In the light of the experience gained in the last 6 months, we have reviewed the level of support that we can provide to the state governments and we have taken the following decisions: to provide more helicopters for logistics support, troop movement, supplies and evacuation; to fund the establishment, strengthening of 400 police stations in the affected districts at the rate of rupees 2 crore per police station on 80-20 basis over a period of 2 years; to sanction additional SPOs to the states; to request the state governments of Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Odisha and West Bengal to create a unified command for anti-Naxal operation; to appoint a retired Major General of the Army as a member of the unified command; to request the 4 state governments to appoint an IG as IG anti-Naxal operations for that state; and to appoint an IG CRPF as IG operations for that state to work in close coordination with the IG anti-Naxal operations of that state; to set up an empowered group chaired by Member Secretary Planning Commission to modify existing norms guidelines in the implementation of various development schemes having regard to the local needs and conditions in the affected districts. Stop.